Hi, welcome back to the PhotoshopTrainingChannel.com. I'm Jesus Ramirez. In this video, I'm going to show you a quick and easy way to remove white backgrounds in Photoshop. This technique is perfect for when you are working with stock images that have isolated backgrounds. Okay, let's get started. So we're going to work with this background and this stock photo of a tractor with a white background, of course. And the tip that I have for you today deals with the magic wand tool. So we're not using the quick selection tool, and we're not using Adobe's artificial intelligence, Adobe Sensei, to select the subject. So just to show you what that means is that with the quick selection tool active, you can click on select subject and it'll make a selection. And the selection is actually quite good, but not good enough because we still get a lot of white in between the wheels and other areas of the tractor. So there's actually a tool that we can use that is much older than Adobe Sensei. It's perhaps Photoshop's first selection tool that will give us a better result. And the fact that it's so limited is why it works so good in this case. And I'm of course talking about the magic wand tool, which allows me to click on a pixel and I select similar pixels. And what you want to do is set your sample size. So this is either the same pixel that you click on, or an average of 3 pixels by 3 pixels, or 5 by 5, and so on. In this case, you can just select point sample, because when you click on white, you'll select, of course, other white pixels. Then you can set your tolerance, which simply means how closely related to the pixel that you click on Photoshop is going to select. You can go from 0, which means exactly the pixel that you click on, or 255, which means basically every pixel in the image. So if I were to click on the image now, it selects the entire layer. See that? And the reason that we're going from 0 to 255 is because those are the luminance values of RGB 8-bit images. So if I double click on the foreground color picker, you'll see the RGB values here. And if I go up, you'll see that the highest number is 255. And the lowest number I could possibly get is, of course, 0. So that's why we can go from 0 to 255. In this case, we don't want to use 0 because we don't want to just select white. We also want to select colors that are just off white. That way we avoid some of that fringing around the edges of the selection. So I'll set the tolerance to 5. Then I'll make sure that anti-alias is checked. That simply creates smooth edges. And I'll make sure that contiguous is unchecked. Contiguous means that you can select pixels of a certain color that are touching. So if I click on this red here, you'll notice that I'll just select that area here of that shade of red, but those pixels are touching. They're contiguous. They're next to each other. If I uncheck that and click on that same area, I'll select the pixels that are of that same color anywhere on this layer. So make sure that that's unchecked. And now we can simply click on the white background and we'll make a selection. Then you can hold shift and click on the transparency. If I disable the background, you'll notice that this is transparency. So I'm holding shift and clicking to add to the selection, and I'll enable the background just so that we can see how this works. If I were to just come into the layers panel and click on the layer mask icon, I'll of course create a layer mask, but I want the opposite of that. And the easiest way of creating an inverted layer mask is to hold Alt option on the Mac when you're clicking on the layer mask icon, and that completely removes the background. Notice that by using this technique, we got into those harder reach places in between the wheels and in other areas of the layer. So I'm going to fit this to screen, and we can further fine tune the selection by just zooming in so that we can see the edges. And then with the layer mask selected, you can click on select and mask, which brings up a workspace where you can fine tune the mask. This tutorial is not about the select and mask workspace, so I'm not going to go into too much detail, but you can watch one of my tutorials where I cover every single tool and slider in this workspace. I highly recommend it. I'll place a link right below in the description. But in this image, we're going to start by smoothing the edges of the mask. They're a bit rough, so I can just increase the smoothing just a tiny bit. And maybe add just a tiny little bit of feather to blur the edges. Again, just a tiny little bit. And I can shift the edge inward like so. And you can, of course, keep fine-tuning the selection until you find something that works for your image. When you're done, you can press OK and double click on the hand tool to fit the image to screen. And you can see that just like that, we were able to remove the white background from the image. Now, obviously this image needs a little bit more work. We need to add shadows and we need to color match the image so that it feels that it's really in that environment. We're not going to cover that in this tutorial, but I will place links down below for two videos that you can watch. A tutorial on color matching that I highly recommend. It's only 90 seconds long, but it's really powerful and it will help you with every composite. So check it out right after this video. And also you can check out this video where I show you how to create shadows in Photoshop, including a technique that most people don't know. And before we finish the tutorial, I would like to say thank you so much for sticking with PTC this year. This is going to be the last tutorial of the year. So I just want to say Happy New Year and thank you so much for all your support. If you're new to the Photoshop training channel, then don't forget to click on that subscribe and notification buttons. Thank you so much for watching. I'll talk to you again in the next tutorial.